Good afternoon. I'm Kildavid, your host for the 9-to-5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. It's been a while, but I'm back again with another edition of Let's Play Classic featuring Assassin's Creed Syndicate, focusing on the Dreadful Crimes DLC. I believe I'm on the last Dreadful Crime. And then I'll wrap that up and then continue with the World War I feature in Assassin's Creed Syndicate. But right now, grab a snack, grab a drink, grab what you need. It's time for Let's Play Classic featuring Assassin's Creed Syndicate. Right now on the 9-to-5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. Here we go. Okay, let's continue where we left off. And this is going to be, as far as I can tell, it's going to be the last Dreadful Crime as part of the Assassin's Creed Syndicate DLC pertaining to the Dreadful Crimes. So I switched from Streamlabs back to OBS because of the stuttering, horrid frame rate of and the quality of my gaming streams. It just wasn't pretty. A little bit of backstory, widget showing up on the side. I'm actually enjoying this game, even though it's set in 1868. But there are some other DLC in Assassin's Creed Syndicate, which I'm going to be debuting like next week. And that, of course, is the Jack the Ripper DLC. The notorious Neo serial killer that stalked the streets of the Whitechapel district of London, England in 1888 in one night. And the case actually remains cold to this day. So we're gonna go on with the last Dreadful Crime. First, let's check the safe by going back to the train. As you can see, it plays much better since I'm using OBS as opposed to Streamlabs. Oh, look at all the money I got. Let's see if there's any NSA. Nope, empty. I'll go on the map. To the last dreadful crime. Okay, here we are. Murder at the palace. 3,000 pounds, 2,000 XP. Reward, cane swords and dove cane sword. There's also Queen Victoria missions. So we'll fast travel this way. So if I switch the game screen, the frame rate is much quicker. That's Freddy Aberline. Solve the perplexing murder of a palace guard.
There has been a murder at the palace. I need you to be careful with this one. Anti-royalist pamphlets have been cropping up and tensions are high. The Queen is very nervous about security.
Queen Victoria, that is.
This way.
Running into people, sorry. Definitely don't run into him. Inspect the palace guardsmen. So in this DLC, you play as detectives during 1868, and that's what the dreadful crimes entail. And you're also partnered with a ghost rider who was that's why you get the expression penny dreadfuls. That's what those entail. Stories of true crime stories. For, you know, like, that was the thing to read. I guess apart from the King James Bible. So inspect the gar. I'm thinking the gar might have been poisoned. So you gotta look for motive, opportunity, and evidence. And a few other things to solve a case. Queen's study. Guardsman's body. A member of the palace guard slumped in a contorted position. Eyes and mouth wide open. The body shows no signs of violence, which means he was likely poisoned. Now I was looking at some clues. Now they're gonna highlight in gold. What we got here? Vase. A priceless vase lying broken on the ground. Signs of a struggle. He could have been hit over the head with it. I'm already making some hypothetic assumptions. Queen's study. Guest list. A list of intimate invitees to the investiture to be held this evening. The queen will knight several industrialists who oppose child labor.
I should return and find out about this.
I got 3 other clues. And then interview a POI or a potential suspect. Letter from Scotland Yard.
To Her Majesty's Private Secretary, Sir Henry Ponsonby. Dear Sir Henry, I am troubled to have to write a concerning, disturbing situation that has recently occurred. Yesterday, we were informed that a young boy had been abducted, and we have rushed to bring this to your attention, and through you, to the attention of Her Majesty, as you think necessary, for we fear the boy's disappearance may be connected to a possible attempt to disrupt this evening's investiture ceremony at the palace. Please be assured, Sir Henry, that we are doing everything possible to locate this child. 1 Arthur Doyle. Doyle's address is appended.
I think Sir Arthur Conan Doyle. He's the author of Sherlock Holmes. That's probably who it's referring to. Broken glass, which means the assailant came through the window. The window is broken. The broken area is large enough to allow access to someone. Okay, there's something else over here. It's like some kind of a safe. It's a vault, marked by deep gashes as if someone attempted to break in.
I should return and find out about this.
Now we need to...
Please, leave the room for a moment. No one is permitted to see me open the safe.
Okay. That's Queen Victoria herself. Wait for the queen.
You cannot imagine that someone was after the scepter. I must see it. I ordered the scepter with the dove to be brought from the tower for tonight's event. Oh, thank heavens! It is untouched.
Returning, I can continue the investigation. Let's interview Queen Victoria.
The poor man. I arrived to find him here, dead as you see him. He gave his life to defend my person. Only I know the combination. The vault contains the very precious scepter with the dove, which I've chosen to be used in tonight's knighthood ceremony. This evening, I will knight several industrialists that have worked to end the practice of child labor. All of London's luminaries are invited.
Thank you, Your Majesty. So some new locations have been unlocked. New scenes of the crime. So let's get out of here. So someone was trying to steal the scepter. But the guard that lost his life was in the way. But only Queen Victoria knew the combination according to her testimony. Guess I can't climb this all the way. Street performers. Or buskers.
Now, it's Mr. Clancy.
These are my rooks.
Here now.
Come on now, girl. Watch where you're driving!
I think after I solve the dreadful crime, I'm probably gonna try going back to the fight club at Westminster, which I have not beaten because the difficulty level is so tough that even when I'm at full strength, I still do. Does this level have 8 rounds? And they're actually tougher. So we're going to Artie's yard.
That's it.
Too bad they put levels of horns on these characters. Run over somebody when you're not trying to. Like, I'm not trying to run out. But there's also children who walk the streets too.
Slowly now.
I like going over the clues of the crime scene before interviewing the POIs, the persons of interest or potential suspects. So there's 2 clues and 2 POIs. Let's go here. There's some post-its right here. Evidence wall. Drawings and texts linking various clues and anomalies throughout the mysteries that have been solved and the resulting penny dreadfuls. The final scrawled message is unfinished, leading to Raymond.
I wonder if someone could tell me more about this.
Oh, I gotta find the other clue. It's those kids again. The first dreadful crime. Fucking dueling. Oh, here we go. Gotta look high and low for these clues. Blank paper. A sheet of apparently blank note paper. Now we get to interview the kids. And the kids, of course, are obviously innocent.
Artie's been all in a state. Think there's some sort of master criminal on the loose. Then this morning, he's gone. Come to think of it, he had been going on about the Queen and all for the last day or two. Seemed to think she was in some sort of trouble.
Now let's interview his friend, Dool.
He said he was onto something. Said everything added in clues. You know, when he thought something was important, he'd write it up in invisible ink. Lemon juice-like.
I did see Artie's friend, Mr. Raymond. He'd just come from Purlock Publishing with his new Penny Dreadful. Seemed very excited about it. I never liked him much.
One thing I've got to ask you.
I did see Artie's friend, Mr. Raymond. He'd just come from Purlock Publishing with his new Penny Dreadful. Seemed very excited about it. I never liked him much.
Someone else around here.
He said he was onto something. Said everything added in clues.
Must be missing something. Get it out of the way.
Did you smoke to read it? If you have a way to make smoke, you can see what it says.
Oh, it's a hidden message.
That's it!
Don't mess with my brooks.
No! Stay in proper! This one's yours! That's it, buddy! Eyes! Quality goods! Well, look for yourself! Rare finds here! Come! Let me see how you do up this thing,
please! I should probably get out of the way.
Pegasus?
And I also loot the bodies.
Disgraceful.
Shut up.
That is a doornail. And good riddance.
Please, spare me.
There's been a murder.
You're looking such up now, are ya?
Come quick. Someone's been killed.
Be right back.
Move it!
Someone's been killed!
Good God.
My God!
right and back.
Wait! Surely that person deserves such a
pain. There you are.
I refuse to believe it.
Quick girl. Terminus for you, my friend.
Serves you right.
Hey, what the hell is that now? Someone's been killed!
I'll find out where you're buried. Don't some of your crap.
I'm half a mind to take you home and feed you to me, Delcy.
I have some work for you.
I thought you'd never ask.
Okay, let's go to their next, locale.
Easy.
Did you smoke to read it? If you have a way to make smoke, you can see what it says.
Ugh.
careful.
Written in invisible ink. Purlock Publishing. Henry Raymond. It's all connected. Follow the clues. There we go. So we need to go to Purlock Publishing. So the message, the blank paper and using invisible ink, or what was used at the time, revealed the message thanks to the use of a smoke bomb that I provided. Unlocked the hidden message. So the next investigation zone is Purlock Publishing, which is the publishing company of Henry Raymond.
What is it, Dono?
The author of the petty dreadfuls that involved me, Evie, and Jacob Frye. So this way. Clues here. Here's the first one. Map. A plan of Buckingham Palace. The Queen's study is circled in black, so the assailant used this map. So someone from Purlock Publishing wanted to steal from the Queen. End up killing Buckingham Palace guard instead and leaving empty-handed. Here we go. Evidence. Anti-royalist pamphlets. Down with the monarchy! An end to all suffering under Victoria. The Queen must pay for her sins. So, who's ever in here is definitely our suspect. Galley proof. A typesetter's galley proof for a penny dreadful. Explosion at the palace. With some descriptive text. Attack at the heart of Britain. Buckingham Palace in flames. Will the Queen escape? This book is written by Henry Raymond.
I don't think Henry Raymond is doing this. Someone is plagiarizing and using, or at least using his name, but it seems as if he had something to do with the attack on Buckingham Palace. So it might have been an associate of his. But it's a pre-made script for an event that kind of hasn't happened, except for the murder of the Buckingham Palace guard. I don't believe Henry Raymond is the assailant. Dynamite crates. Empty munitions crates clearly marked Prescott Munitions, number 408.
An explosion at Buckingham Palace. I must warn them.
Oh dear, that's why. The nighting of the ceremony.
Need some muscles,
Standing ready if you
I'll
need help.
Let's go. We gotta get over there. I guess we'll go out by the window. For an open window. Because the dynamite's gone and it's already there. And I don't think Henry Raymond is trying to write something like that. I don't think he's trying to run afoul at Queen Victoria for the sake of a novel.
Huh? I wonder what that is. Fuck off, clumsy fool!
Money your damn business. So only when I switch the video where I'm seeing the frame rate is stuttering, so let's get back. That's one of the known drawbacks of the low-end video card. Entering the strand, we need to get to the guard quickly. Quickest way to travel. Or at least the most practical way to travel. Huh.
There's at least 100 people here for the knighthood ceremony. The Queen will use the scepter with the dove for the knighting. She'll arrive precisely at 1 o'clock.
Evacuate the party, yes. Let's do that quick. We've got 1 minute. Holy shit.
What's going on, man?
And evacuate
the scepter with the dove.
Everyone must leave!
Most extraordinary.
Terribly nice to see you.
Everyone must leave!
Most extraordinary.
Oh, shit.
Is something happening?
Yeah. Uh-oh. I hate to do this, I'm about to restart.
I've saved them. Nothing is happening. No explosion. What is this? I've been tricked. Raymond, why has he done this?
Oh, Raymond, I guess he did.
You are more naive than you appear.
Yes, he is.
Look beyond the obvious, beyond surface appearances.
Nothing but a showman. So many people makes everything more dramatic.
I found the same clues you found. I knew there was to be an explosion, and I led you here to save everyone. I'm as mystified as you are that nothing happened. Seems to me you've created the perfect diversion, haven't you? You've helped me herd all those dreary people to certain death. We shall hear the explosion presently. I found the same clues you found. I knew there was to be an explosion, and I led you here to save everyone. I'm as mystified as you are that nothing happened. Seems to me you've created the perfect diversion, haven't you? You've helped me herd all those dreary people to certain death. We shall hear the explosion presently. That, my dear, makes no sense. Right.
What are you talking about? How dare you? I can't believe this is happening.
I brought him his invitation to the knighthood ceremony, the one with the special scepter.
newspaper. Several articles, one about the coming ceremony wherein the Queen will use the storied scepter with the dove to knight an industrialist.
Never trust a man who tells you what you want to hear. He's after something.
It's not a bad idea. Perhaps next time. I needed you to distract everyone so that I could quietly assassinate Her Majesty the Queen. Assassinate the Queen? Whatever for? A man like me can take anything he wants, even the Queen's most beloved item of all her crown. The scepter with the dove taken with your help. What could better display my genius?
No one questions you when you wear a uniform.
A large, distinctive spider coiled up in there.
I suspect the solution will turn on geometry.
I am a fellow of many skills. Cracking a safe is but one. I simply watched the Queen open the safe when you arrived. I threatened the Queen with her very life. She told me the combination in a trice. Quite right. The dead guard was I. The spider venom allowed me to fake my death. I had a perfect view from where I lay.
He posed as the guard.
I have stolen the Queen's most prized possession, the scepter with the dove. Think of it. I have outfoxed you, the most cunning detective in Britain. I mocked you by leaving clues for you at every turning point. Now I have the scepter. proof positive of my superiority.
Okay.
Evie, wake up! It's Raymond. He's taken Artie hostage.
Oh, great.
They're on the roof. Jacob's here to help you, Evie.
Watch where you're going.
Looks like bother to me.
Can't switch.
What?
So, Henry Raymond. Responsible for insurrection on the Queen.
Nice Parliament. Flute, but you've come up short, Miss Frye.
Do not threaten me or come any nearer.
Evie!
This lad's very life depends upon it.
You have done well. Indeed, far better than I expected.
You've been busy, Evie. It won't be long now.
This is a poor ending to one of your mystery novels, Mr. Raymond. The innocent young boy is threatened with death. I really expected much more from you, sir.
On the contrary, it makes for an excellent ending, Miss Frye. As far as my readers are concerned, the more lurid, the better. Must I remind you, do not move.
I'm not moving. No chance of that. Let's all just take a deep breath, shall we? Let's stay calm, shall we? No need to do anything rash.
No, I'm quite calm, Miss Frye.
Bye-bye, asshole.
I suppose this means our detective days are over. But what about you, Artie?
I'm glad I survived Mr. Raymond's insanity, but sadly he won't be here anymore to write more books.
Arthur.
A great loss, I'm sure.
Sir,
I'm quite serious, Miss Evie. Me and my friends wait every week to read the next number and find out what happened next.
Why don't you write some yourself?
A fellow would have to be very clever indeed.
Sounds like you'd be in your element, my dear.
The gruesome Whitechapel murders by Artie.
I should think I would use my full name. By Artie Conan Doyle.
Yeah.
But he's Arthur. Sounds more of a serious fella.
This was young Sir Arthur Conan Doyle. Oh, I lost half of that with the accusations. Yeah. It's okay. So, it's a perfect closure to their dreadful crimes. So that was the Dreadful Crimes DLC of Assassin's Creed Syndicate. Now, in a future episode, I'm going to wrap up the World War I mini-story, where it takes place, I think, 1914 or 1916, and United Kingdom's involvement in World War I. That'll be next. Then I will continue on with Assassin's Creed Syndicate DLC Jack the Ripper in a future episode beginning next week. So let's continue on. Check inventory. Dove cane sword equip and upgrade. So I got all the guns. So I gotta get the Bodica's torque in order to upgrade. Dinosaur talent for that one. When the anvil turns black, it means the item is ready to be crafted. I think I'm gonna switch to Jacob.
Runs faster than you!
That's going to be for the last Maharaja. In this case, Duli Singh. But that's going to be for a later DLC. Yep, I'm already in Westminster, so let's go to the fight club. Violet is my favorite. So looking at the progression log. Yep. Did all the dreadful crimes.
Together now.
That's it.
Easy does it.
Oh.
let's try to win the fight club. There's 8 rounds here, and I've never beaten it yet.
Fall out of your mind? How about a nice clean fight? Goodness, I thought I was going to die of boredom. Now, into the ring with
you. So start beating the masses. Quick. Stakes get raised. We gotta get on. It's possible to get the number 10. Eat the toughest. See? I told you. Run, keep running.
sometime, you hear? The next contestant. Any last words?
Listen, it's over the floor!
Sometime, you hear?
I'm getting anyway. Switch to Evie. Look at me. Think they would go easy on me because the character is a woman, but nope.
Hooray! Finally, some real talent.
Belching on screen.
Splendid! Well, hop into the ring then. The competition will begin shortly.
Guess not. Last hour.
Don't just attack her one at a time!
Proud, mates!
You regret that. Someone get her from behind. I'll gut you like a fish.
Inspiring. I hope you'll grace the ring with your presence again.
Forward, you better spook.
Don't just attack her one at a time.
To go. Keep going. It's about to get tough. Oh, here we go. Take him out quickly.
Where do I tax this guy?
What's wrong, huh? Break your bones! I hope your prayers are in order! Somebody get him from behind!
I'll enjoy carving you!
Take on our champion to be. Oh,
Dare face me! Shield flag! Wait for it! Slide the rope!
You can do better than that.
Make sure she comes out of the way.
You need a bloody heart attack.
Tried, but I'll get better. Now I'll go check on the safe. It's already full. So empty it and bank the money. If you are enjoying the stream, if you like the content I'm bringing you, please consider following, subscribing, and hitting the notification bell to the 9to5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel, as I'll be continuing to produce additional Let's Play gaming livestream walkthroughs such as Assassin's Creed Syndicate and many others. And if you'd like to contribute to the channel, I do have a Patreon listed in the description. I would appreciate that as well. And now, continue on with the stream of Assassin's Creed Syndicate. I guess we can do this one. First, let's talk.
Look, no fun.
I don't need anything, I guess.
Do come back.
I'm still gonna empty the safe.
Prepare for a brawl, Evie. We've been knighted. Gives a whole new twist to hiding in plain sight.
Mr. Henry Irving himself.
Okay, I'm back. Emptied out the safe. Charles girl. And that's the Charles Darwin and Charles Dickens conspiracy. This is the one that's part of the Charles Darwin, Darwin and Dickens conspiracy. But there's always some raids. Yep, some high dollar fight club. See, there's so many opportunities to make money. Train robber, let's do that. So we're gonna go about the last 20 minutes of this stream. In 1867, a woman died at the underground station. The inquest verdict was death from natural causes accelerated by the suffocating atmosphere. That's a cover-up. At mid-century, there was 12 London pubs named Adam and Eve, 8 named Noah's Ark. How original can they get? Death from above! Geronimo!
She's right. We'll be out of the street.
Perhaps it's some way of negotiating.
Stop! You'll get us all killed!
Report these nuts in your mouth.
Come on! from blowing our heads.
Good haul, boss.
What's she doing?
chance here, Swin.
This river was really clear. I hear it's clean.
Again, by all means.
Continue on for the future episode tomorrow at the same time. Let's go to the portal. There it is. Of the stream. He was so fat that he couldn't wipe his own ass. Can you believe that? Strange but true. Send in the royal wiper! Oh, you can fast travel the portal that way. That's cool. I'm gonna go right into the future. 1916 or something. Sir Winston Churchill. Gas street lights were lit individually. Lamplighters carried a ladder, climbed up, turned on the stopcock, held a light to it, climbed down, and moved on to the next before turning them on the same. Yeah. I need to read those much faster enough. Can't, I'm not gonna bother with that. So this is still gonna be a pretty. So this is Lydia Frye, the descendant of the Frye Twins. Probably the niece or somebody, I'm not sure. This is what all I got left. Master Spy. Zeppelin Raid, I can do that. What all do I have? So this entire block is all I have, but it looks like it. I guess I'm gonna do a zeppelin raid. Save the planet from a solar flare, Desmond activates the Grand Temple. In doing so, Juno is free and consciousness enters the world's networks. Yeah.
Someone's on the way!
Look out! We're being boarded! Fight them off! In position, Ash! Gun at the ready!
That's upcoming. In 1861, a fire on the south of the Thames spread over 11 acres and burned for nearly 3 weeks. Fat running out of the warehouse set the Thames.
Now,
this.
Well, that's gonna do it with this edition of Let's Play Classic featuring Assassin's Creed Syndicate on the 9to5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. I'll be back tomorrow at the same time to conclude the World War I episode of Assassin's Creed Syndicate Let's Play Gaming Livestream Walkthrough tomorrow. Until then, I'm Kildavid for the 9to5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. Please, stay safe.